Join us in welcoming the distinguished members of our platform party.
Thank you. Good morning. My name is Richard Larson. As president of the Stony Brook University Senate, I am honored to formally open today's ceremony. Here now, in the presence of the candidates for academic recognition, faculty, administration, alumni, honored guests, and friends of the State University of New York at Stony Brook, our commencement ceremony is hereby commenced. Please rise as you are able for the singing of our national anthem that will be led by Danielle Nanny from our Department of Music.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star spangle banner yet wave o'er the land of the free?
Please be seated. It is now my distinct pleasure to present to you the president of Stony Brook University, Dr. Maurie McInnis.
Welcome to all present at this historic commencement. Welcome to our SUNY trustee and president of the SUNY Student Assembly, the members of the faculty and staff, to our parents and friends of our graduates, and above all, to the graduating class of 2021. It is my pleasure to introduce someone renowned for his extraordinary service to the state of New York. Although he's a Brooklyn resident, he has been a tireless advocate for Long Island and a close friend of the Stony Brook family, United States Senator Chuck Schumer.
Hello, Stony Brook. This is Senator Chuck Schumer, and it's my honor to address the faculty and staff, the families and friends of the graduates, but most of all, you, the class of 2021. Everyone says your senior year in college will be the most memorable, and for many of you, it probably has been. The challenge of these moments are truly unique, but so has been our collective response. The fact that we're still celebrating this graduation just goes to show that New Yorkers won't let anything stop us from honoring what's so important in life. Nothing can take away from the fact that you've earned a degree from such a fine institution of higher learning. So, class of 2021, My message to you is simple. Right now, it may feel like the future is uncertain, but don't let the harshness of this past year prevent you from seizing new opportunities. And we need your help and your courage to rebuild our country even stronger than it was before. So to the graduates, I say once again, congratulations, good luck, Godspeed.
Thank you, Senator Schumer. Thank you for being here today, joining us in celebrating this remarkable commencement. Graduates, I can feel your excitement. Today marks our return to in-person commencement. We are celebrating scholars who have persevered and even thrived during remote and asynchronous education. And we're able to do it alongside the friends and family who supported them all the way. That is something worth celebrating. And I'd like to begin by leading a round of applause. First, for all of our guests here who have been integral to our graduates in their journey and in our journey. Graduates, please rise and give your friends and family an applause and thank you. And now, friends and family, it's your turn. Let's stand and give a big cheer for the class of 2021. Graduates, you have learned and grown more in your time in university than anyone could have predicted. On this momentous occasion, let us reflect on the qualities that will distinguish our Stony Brook University class of 2021. Stony Brook is a place of community. Between disciplines, students, staff, and faculty, and neighbors and partners around the world. During their time here, our students make vital connections, friends and mentors who will buoy them personally and professionally for the rest of their lives. In a year of physical distancing, our class of 2021 learned different ways to collaborate and connect. You had to reorganize your home lives, prioritize health, maintain friendships, and adapt to new modes of learning. And in the final year of your journey, you had to find community and connection during global upheaval. It was a daunting task, yet time and time again, your class met this challenge with positivity, ingenuity, and hope. As the state worked rapidly to care for patients and fight COVID-19, our students ran test sites, provided medical attention, and used their knowledge in medicine and healthcare to keep the community safe. I am inspired by the way today's graduates have used their individual skills and interests to support one another. I am proud to say that with the leadership of the class of 2021, this year's Stony Brook University was able to conduct a combined 29% of classes fully in person or in hybrid form and keep the resident students on campus without any significant outbreaks. That is a remarkable achievement. Also in the last year, our nation has made a step change in acknowledging past and current systemic racism. Students of the class of 2021 were on the vanguard in demanding racial justice and working to promote equity and inclusivity within our own departments and organizations, even in times of exhaustion. As the class of 2021 sets out to make its contributions to our society, I cannot imagine a group of students more capable of moving these conversations into action. In times of strife, we will look to you as a constructive voice and positive energy towards a better future for all. I recently had the opportunity to see the incredible art made by our graduating seniors on display in Zucker Gallery. Much of their work reflected on the longings of isolation and the emotional extremes of the past year. But significantly, it was clear that these gifted artists had found great beauty in unexpected and intimate spaces. They had found real human connection in their art, and this is indicative of the kind of emotionally complex, mature perspectives that will differentiate the class of 2021. In times of tumult, I know we can turn to you for creativity, beauty, and perspective. Class of 2021, your unparalleled experience has given you a wisdom that was unimaginable 18 months ago. You are leaving Stony Brook with a lived, first-hand knowledge of the human condition in all its foibles, nuances, and possibilities. I submit that this commencement has unrivaled symbolic value. The world is opening up, and you are joining leaders in a new world with new possibilities. It thrills me to see the class of 2021 embark on its next steps. As you join Stony Brook's more than 200,000 alumni across the globe, we want you to stay connected with Stony Brook, engage with our passionate community, and consider this university a second home to celebrate all of your achievements. Your track record is singular. You've graduated under unmatched circumstances, showing grace, determination, and resilience in the face of adversity. Your talent and experience can make an indelible impact on the world. You have seen the unexpected and pernicious challenges that life can deliver. And already the class of 2021 has met many of these challenges and has never stopped learning. For years to come, we here at Stony Brook University will look with admiration at your demonstrated strength, your proven compassion, and your earned wisdom. Congratulations, class of 2021. It is now my honor to introduce the president of the undergraduate student government, Asna Jamal, for a special presentation from the class of 2021.
Congratulations, class of 2021. I am Asna Jamal. I am the president of the undergraduate student government, and I'm excited to present this year's senior class gift. In the 2004-2005 academic year, the class representative and the dean of students established the student giving campaign, which allowed students like us an opportunity to give back and show our support for Stony Brook. Over the years, students have raised hundreds of thousands of dollars to fund meaningful initiatives on our campus. They have supported scholarships, student life, advanced the reach of the university's research and service missions, and helped to restore communities during times of need. Under the leadership of the Senior Legacy Council, the class of 2021 mobilized to continue this important tradition. As a result of their leadership and vision, many seniors have contributed to this year's class gift. You can identify these super seawolves by the red and black generosity cords that we are wearing today. I would like to take this time to recognize my fellow Executive Council member, Jolina Podolsky, who has also helped with the efforts to push this initiative. So Jolina, thank you so much for your good and important work. As contributors, we are not only helping to leave our mark here at Stony Brook, but are also demonstrating our citizenship to the world and taking the first step in becoming active and loyal alumni. President McInnis, as the USG president, I am excited to report that the senior class has again raised several thousands of dollars to support the Stony Brook Fund for Excellence, general scholarships, the Student Emergency Fund, Student Life, the Stoller Center, and many other important parts of our university. We hope that our contribution will allow us to leave a lasting legacy to the university and community. To my fellow graduates, thank you for contributing, and I look forward to seeing you at homecoming on October 23rd. Congrats, Seawolves.
Thank you, Asna. The class of 2021 has raised over $24,000 for Stony Brook University. Thank you for your hard work and dedication to Stony Brook University. We are so proud. And now I'd like to introduce this year's student speaker, Kiara Arias. Kiara from New York City is graduating with her degree in political science, as well as minors in journalism and media arts. She has been a highly engaged and trusted student leader at Stony Brook, serving as the Director of Diversity and Inclusion Affairs for the undergraduate student government, a resident assistant, and a digital journalism teaching assistant. She has also completed marketing and communications internships and served on several university committees focused on student engagement at Stony Brook. After graduation, she will intern with the American Civil Liberties Union. Please join me in welcoming Kiara.
Hello, Stony Brook graduates. I'm Kiara Arias, and just like you, I'm proud to be part of the class of 2021. I'm grateful for the opportunity to share a few reflections with you, our undergraduate and graduate students, celebrating this milestone today, both here in person and virtually. When I think back over my 4 years at Stony Brook, the first word that comes to mind is unforgettable. We've interacted with and learned from so many diverse people from all across the world through our classes, clubs, and campus events. We spent many late nights studying, hanging out with friends, sharing our life stories, and having fun. We've been mentored, challenged, and supported by Stony Brook's faculty and staff to be our best. We've been cheered on by our parents, family, children, and loved ones. We've developed important leadership skills that'll take us far in life. We've taken part in some of Stony Brook's best traditions, like Roth Regatta and Midnight Scream. And we've had to explain to our family and friends back home, what's a seawolf? Part of our collective experience is that we all have faced challenges along the way towards earning our degree. We've worked hard to achieve success, but we've also overcome obstacles. During my first week at Stony Brook, September 3rd, 2017, in the late evening to be exact, the residents in Simpson and I faced a short-lived challenge. That's the night the lights on campus fizzled out. People panicked, but the RAs, always ready, handed out glow sticks in the hallways and urged everyone to remain calm. While we were thrust into darkness for a short time, the lights soon returned and our lives went back to normal. While this was only a momentary test of our resilience, it foreshadowed the significant challenge we would all face a few years later. In March 2020, the COVID pandemic affected everything in our lives, and many people in our campus community experienced uncertainty, loss, and isolation. But as Seawolves always do, we again found light by working together, taking one step at a time, and never giving up. Through it all, we learned that whatever we're confronted with, whether it's a blackout or a pandemic, we're unstoppable. Our time at Stony Brook has been filled with so many great experiences surrounded by incredible people. Stony Brook has given us the space to chart our own path, make our own mistakes, help us be comfortable with the idea of not being perfect, and given us the confidence that we have the tools to be successful. As we look to the future, I encourage us all to continue finding beauty in the ordinary little things. When we do this, all moments become memorable, and we'll find ourselves smiling even on our worst day, giving our lives a whole new meaning. Congratulations, class of 2021 graduates. We made it.
I'm Eric Wertheimer, and as Dean of the Graduate School and Vice Provost for Graduate and Professional Education,
I am honored to confer the highest of all academic degrees and to recognize the accomplishments of doctoral candidates who have earned PhDs. Yeah. Hooding a graduate who has completed the requirements for a doctoral degree is a symbolic academic ritual that celebrates many years of study and investigation. It's an important and significant moment for both the graduates and their advisors. I invite President McInnis and Provost Goldbart to come forward for today's hooding of our candidates.
So we begin with the graduate program in art. Megan Hines, advised by Katie Siegel and hooded by Eric Wertheimer. And now, from the graduate program in cultural analysis and theory, Jean Young John, advised by Isabella Kalinowska Blackwood. And now from the graduate program in English, Caitlin Duffy, advised by Andrew Newman. Also from the graduate program in English, John Hegestad, advised by Elise Graham. Continuing with the graduate program in English, Sarah Santos, advised by Justin Johnston. As well from the graduate program in English, Arsevi Seran, advised by Peter Manning and hooded by Eric Wertheimer. Next from the graduate program in English, Megan Buckley, advised by Roger Thompson. And now from the graduate program in Hispanic Languages and Literature, Natalia Chamorro, advised by Adrián Pérez Melgosa and hooded by Kathleen Vernon. Also from the graduate program in Hispanic Languages and Literature, Ennis Addison, advised by Kathleen Vernon and Lena Burgos Lafuente. And now from the graduate program in History, David Purificato, advised by Wilbur Miller. Moving on to the graduate program in music, Raisa Fallman, advised by Alan Kay. And next from the graduate program in music, Catherine Vetter, advised by Alan Kay. And next from the graduate program in music, Brian Olson, advised by Kevin Cobb and hooded by Perry Goldstein. And next from the graduate program in music, Natasha Stolmack, hooded by Eric Wertheimer. Also from the graduate program in music, Alan Hankers, advised by Daria Semogen and hooded by Nirmali Fenn. Next from the graduate program in music, Elizabeth Schmidt, advised by David Jolly and Margaret Shadell, and hooded by Margaret Shadell. Next from the graduate program in music, Atao Liu, advised by Frank Morelli and hooded by Nirmali Fenn. Next from the graduate program in music, Stephen McLean, advised by Kevin Cobb and hooded by Perry Goldstein. And next from the graduate program in music, Samuel Beebe, advised by Matthew Barnson. Next from the graduate program in music, Chelsea Lowe, advised by Matthew Barnson. And next from the graduate program in music, Niloufar Nourbakhsh, advised by Matthew Barnson. Next from the graduate program in music, Christopher Bill, advised by Ray Anderson. And also from the graduate program in music, Marisa Santos Oligario, advised by Perry Goldstein and Frank Morelli, and hooded by Perry Goldstein. And next from the graduate program in music, Joanne Oana Dimitrescu, advised by Philip Setzer and hooded by Perry Goldstein. Moving on to the graduate program in sociology, Charlar Chetin, advised by Crystal Fleming and hooded by Kathleen Fallon.
Where are the remotes? Okay.
And moving to the graduate program in philosophy, Adam Blair, advised by Edward Casey and hooded by Anne O'Byrne. So now we're going to read the names of all of our doctoral candidates who are with us remotely. So we will not be hooding any physical people at this moment, but we will be honoring their accomplishments by reading their names and their advisors out loud. So from the graduate program in art, we have one candidate, Yifei Cheng, who is advised by Isaac Burbech. And we have several from the graduate program in music. Yuting Cheng, advised by Alan Kay. Liang Dong, advised by Hagai Shaham. Jorge Huelga Garcia, advised by Lawrence Dutton. Yuting Huang, advised by Tina Dahl. Ri Lee, advised by Blake Henson. Renu Martin Pei, advised by Jennifer Frauchi. Zeshun Shen, advised by Susan Kaiserman. Yezu Wu, advised by Perry Goldstein. Yen Chen Wu, advised by Frank Morelli. Bai Yang, advised by Christina Dahl. And then one remote graduate from the program in philosophy, Audrey Lane Ellis, advised by Megan Craig.
One more round of applause, really loud. Congratulations to all today's doctoral candidates. The master's is an advanced degree signifying the acquisition of specialized theoretical and practical knowledge beyond that required for the baccalaureate degree. Master's graduates must demonstrate advanced analytical skills, complex problem solving, critical evaluation, and independent scholarship appropriate to their chosen fields. Will the candidates for master's degrees please rise? President McInnis, it is my honor to acknowledge the accomplishment of these candidates. Candidates, please be seated. I would now like to invite Provost Paul Goldbart forward for the presentation of honors candidates.
As provost, I'm honored to present to you our undergraduate honors candidates who are graduating today with distinction. Degrees with distinction are conferred upon candidates who have completed at least 55 credits at Stony Brook, have letter grades assigned to at least 80% of their coursework, and attained the requisite GPA in their program. The levels of distinction are cum laude, graduating with honor and representing the 85th percentile of all students, magna cum laude, graduating with great honor and representing the 93rd percentile, and summa cum laude, graduating with the greatest honor, representing the 98th percentile of all students. Attainment of a degree with distinction is indicated on each of these students' diplomas and on their permanent academic record. Will candidates graduating with the distinctions of cum laude, magna cum laude, and summa cum laude please stand and be recognized? President McInnis, it is with great pride that I present to you this year's honors candidates. Honors candidates, you may be seated. Now please join me in welcoming Nicole Sampson, Distinguished Professor of Chemistry and Dean of the College of Arts and Sciences, to begin the presentation of today's candidates for degree conferral.
Thank you, Provost Goldbart. I would also like to acknowledge all of our deans, chairs, directors, and faculty who are joining us today on the podium. So thank you for being here. And welcome, College of Arts and Sciences, May 2021, graduates, parents, partners, siblings, and friends. Thank you for joining us today to honor our students and be a part of this special celebration. Yesterday afternoon, we learned the news of the passing of one of our seniors graduating today, Thomas Reyes. Our colleague, Vice President for Student Affairs and Dean of Students Rick Gatto, provided the following words that I'd like to share with you. Tommy earned his Bachelor of Arts degree in history at Stony Brook and was described by his faculty members as passionate, committed, and always upbeat. In an article written about Tommy just last month, he talked about pursuing a lifelong dream to write a memoir called Rise Above, a story that reflected on his physical condition, muscular dystrophy. In the article, Tommy shared that staying positive isn't easy, but I need to always have courage no matter the circumstances. Life's hard, so you've got to make the most of it. Tommy had a profound and lasting impact on our Stony Brook community, and today we celebrate his determination, motivation, and accomplishments. Please join me in a moment of silence to honor Tommy Reyes and all the others that we have lost in this very difficult year. Today, through our three commencement celebrations for the College of Arts and Sciences, I'm proud to present nearly 2,100 commencement candidates for May 2021. The college is graduating 1,840 undergraduate students, 130 master's and advanced certificates, and approximately 135 DMA and PhD students. In today's ceremony, we will be graduating students with degrees, get ready, in Africana Studies, Art History and Criticism, Studio Art, Asian and Asian American Studies, Cinema and Cultural Studies, Cultural Analysis and Theory, English, French, Italian, Romance Languages and Literature, Hispanic Languages and Literature, Spanish Languages and Literature, History, Linguistics, Computational Linguistics, the TESOL program, Multidisciplinary Studies, Music, Music Performance, Philosophy, History of Philosophies East and West, Political Science, Public Policy, Sociology, Theater Arts, Women's and Gender Studies, and Women's Gender and Sexuality Studies. Woo! And I'm pleased that we have representatives from these programs with us today on the platform. I'm also pleased to welcome one of our alumni today as well, Mr. Larry Emmert, class of 1971, BA in Political Science. Would you please stand? Mr. Emmert joins us on this 50th anniversary of his graduation from Stony Brook, and for the first time ever is wearing a cap and gown. He received his degree in January 1971. Mr. Emmert was unable to attend the May 1971 commencement ceremony as he was serving our country to fulfill his military commitment. Mr. Emmert, we are honored to have you join us today and so pleased that you are finally celebrating this important milestone in your Stony Brook regalia. Let's give Mr. Emmert a final round of applause. The past year has brought new challenges unlike many of us have ever known. We've stepped out of our comfort zones, learned new technologies, engaged with each other virtually and now in person. We've become accustomed to quarantines, social distancing, Zoom meetings, classes and parties, and a lot at home. Our students, faculty, and staff have indeed risen to the occasion to do the best we could do in the most challenging of circumstances. I've heard from many faculty and staff that the behavior and adaptability of our students during this difficult time has been phenomenal. and our efforts have been successful as we begin to see the light at the end of this very long tunnel. Here we are today, fortunate to celebrate this very important milestone in person, with each of you about to cross this stage, hearing your name and receiving the degree you've worked tirelessly for. As an educator for more than 25 years, I've witnessed the many impressive achievements of Stony Brook's hardworking students. You come from very diverse backgrounds, adapting and bringing your own culture and customs to our vibrant community. And it's very evident that you embrace change and challenge, taking advantage of opportunities that will have a positive impact on your future, whether engaged in research, benefiting from hands-on experiences through internships and other experiential learning positions, participating in clubs and organizations, both on and off campus, and more often while working part or full time to support your education. So I applaud each and every one of you for your strength, resilience, and perseverance. It has not been easy, and yet here you are, about to embark on the next chapter of your lives. It may still be unwritten, but today is where it begins. So I congratulate each of you, our amazing Seawolves, in your Stony Brook red, our courageous and dedicated students who did not lose sight of the finish line, eager to complete this phase of your education and achieve your dreams. Our next wave of leaders. You made it, and it will be an experience you will never forget. Cheers to each of you. President McInnis, it is with great pleasure that I present to you this year's candidates for the degrees of Masters of Arts, Master of Fine Arts, Master of Music, Bachelor of Science, Bachelor of Arts, and Advanced Graduate Certificates in the College of Arts and Sciences.
It is now my honor to invite President McInnis to join me as we recognize today's candidates. At this time, I would like to invite all candidates for professional, master's, bachelor's degrees, and advanced graduate certificates to rise. President McInnis, these students have met the graduation requirements set by the Board of Trustees. As the representative of their faculty, I am proud to present them to you and respectfully request that you confer upon them the degrees and certificates for which they are qualified.
As we bring our candidates forward, please know that we will be integrating the names of our virtual attendees.
Aka Savell Akdagan.
Christopher Avitable.
Marta Baumiller. Are you on? Maxine S. Formis.
Tonya Badanishi.
Ryan Bloom.
Manwai Cheng.
Ya Ting Cheng.
Yefai Cheng.
Heather DiMartino.
Kenya Giamara Guevara Marara.
Stephanie Galuzzo. Lynn Hollerman.
Joshua Koff.
Jasmeet Kaur.
Alan Hankers.
Michael Cavanaugh.
Courtney Lohr.
Atal Liu.
Elena Lesquadro.
Natalie Lauraino.
Jacqueline Manassian.
Chelsea Lowe.
Francis Milady.
Yai Tai Liu.
Brandon Rios.
Glenn Martolani.
Zafrum Mustafa.
Thank you.
Carmen Sequin.
Lawrence Larry Emmert.
Daniel Abruzzese, magna cum laude.
Michael Stanton.
Adam Strominga.
Juliet Accomando. Nilo Far Narkabash.
Orelawa Adewale.
Marissa Algalario.
Daniela Aguilar.
Gregory Palmer.
Mahima Alam.
David Purificato.
Jessica Alberto Cum Laude.
Matthew Renahan.
Celia Allen Smith.
James Wrigley.
Catherine Hazel Alvarado, magna cum laude.
Riney Rolock.
Nadia Anouf.
Jessica Shuri.
Alex Angerman.
Gabriella Serpicchio.
Chiara Arias.
Jennifer Snell.
Oops.
Dallin Ashdown.
Attica Saratokin.
Eli Nakuso Avila II, Eli Narcisu Avila Cum Laude.
Esmeralda Lutz Soto.
Jonathan Baez, summa cum laude.
Terry Vieira.
Jermaine Bailey.
Jennifer Wilcox.
Daniel Bailey.
Yenchu Wu.
Abdulay Barry.
Danielle Bailey. Bai Young. Nathan York.
Esmeralda Luz Soto.
Aline Araujo Teixeira.
Gavansa Zara Galazde.
Yuanzi Lee.
Abdulay Berry.
Princess Balen. Carmela Batista. Ricardo Batista. Lauren Bobron. Rachel Beldock, summa cum laude.
Angela Berdon.
Michael Bilfinger.
Shane Blake.
David Bonella.
Justin Bolsey. Brianna Bueno.
Justin Burns.
Gabriela Cabrera.
Donovan Bush.
Christian Callen.
Thomas Campo.
Christian Capabianco.
Brian Chan.
Ryan Chen.
Manwei Cheng. Eugene Chung, summa cum laude.
Chai Yung Cheng.
Sarah City, cum laude.
Michelle Sina. Remy Concepcion.
John Korpak.
Tyler Cruz. Chai Yung Ching.
Camila Kumbe, magna cum laude.
Mary Dada.
Hold up. We just don't know who's here.
I don't either. That's why we're not doing this. It'll look the next time, the next ceremony, we're not doing this. It's okay. Get through it. It's okay.
Nicole Daly, magna cum laude.
Alyssa Ulisudirgo, magna cum laude.
Niambi Daniels.
Stephen DeFiti.
Ashley DeLay.
Dishu Di Halu.
Hallie Dillon.
L-E-It D-Ni Ru, summa cum laude.
Brandon Dixon, magna cum laude.
Madeline Dorr, cum laude.
Sylvanie Dorsonville.
Aiden Doxy, summa cum laude.
Paul Dreyer, summa cum laude.
Richard Dudley Shipman.
Peter Duffy.
Nicolette Andres, summa cum laude.
Rachel Eng.
Meredith Epstein, cum laude.
Jameer Eskridge.
Taylor Esposito, summa cum laude.
Abigail Farias, cum laude.
John Ferriello.
Emily Fish.
Maria Florian.
Genesis Gallo, cum laude.
Jonathan Garcia, magna cum laude.
Francesca Casal, summa cum laude.
Michelle Nardelli.
Michael Germer.
Rose Goldberg, summa cum laude.
Gwendolyn Goodyear, summa cum laude.
Lucy Gordon, summa cum laude.
Declan Graham, summa cum laude.
Harrison Granger.
Jake Grossman, cum laude.
Pong Wan, cum laude.
Mohamadou Gaye.
Shuraya Gupta.
Jacqueline Gurevich, magna cum laude.
Samantha Hase, magna cum laude.
Danielle Holivy, summa cum laude.
Rebecca Hansen, cum laude.
Shannon Heffernan, magna cum laude.
We'll re-announce you. Kennedy Itzkowitz.
Dalant Halams.
My name is Aline Teixeira, and it's summa cum laude, and I would like to hear both.
Absolutely. Let me make sure it's on your card. It's okay.
I'm going right. Christopher Higgins.
Brian Herman.
Julia Hayes, cum laude.
Victoria Hughes.
Jaquita Jackson, cum laude.
Samithaha Ibrahim. Diane Jajaliski.
Danielle Jacob.
Raymond Giannis, magna cum laude.
Liliana Jerez.
Ryan Jimenez, summa cum laude.
Kathleen Johnson, magna cum laude.
Isaiah Jones.
Makiba Latouche.
Christina Waldalowski.
Matthew Burnett.
Myra Gomez. Victoria DeAngelis, cum laude.
Tanya Guerrero.
Alexa Ander-Kovich.
You said his name correctly, but summa cum laude. Ladies and gentlemen, with summa cum laude honors, she's walking again because we said her name wrong and we're going to make sure we get it right. Ladies and gentlemen,
Aline Teixeira.
Aline Teixeira. Way to go, Aline. Teixeira, summa cum laude. And we're going to make a big deal about you too. Where's your card, young lady?
I got it right here. Maya, okay. Right? Maya. Maya Gomez. Okay. Maya Gomez.
We're doing the best we can, everybody. Be patient. Some of the graduates are virtual, and we just don't know who's walking and who's not today, so we're trying to include everybody. Bless you all. Congratulations. We're going to keep going strong.
What's your name?
Gabriela Carrera.
Gabriela Carrera, summa cum laude. Langa Kudisha.
Khadija Saad, magna cum laude.
Filza Siddiqui, cum laude. Ayushi Raj.
Abugal Kid, summa cum laude.
Maria Karamitis, cum laude.
Ryan Connie.
Anika Shuderi, summa cum laude.
Jennifer Kim, summa cum laude.
Thomas Keenan, cum laude.
Ashley Kowalczyk, summa cum laude.
Dizzy Kieran.
Thomas Kirby. Danielle Nanny.
Justin Morgan.
Joanna Sue, magna cum laude.
Nicholas, right? Nicholas LaChance.
Nicholas Lamare.
Ciara Lampa.
Samantha Lang, summa cum laude.
Millicent LeClaire, summa cum laude.
Vanessa Lee, cum laude.
Suji Lee, cum laude.
Unche Lee, magna cum laude.
Beres Luesh.
Mangwa Lee, magna cum laude.
Ryan Licht.
Victoria Lombardi, summa cum laude.
Kelsey Loregno.
Philip Ladlesquero.
Victoria Lasquadro, summa cum laude.
Kira Luna, magna cum laude.
Colette Lynch.
Are you Brenna?
Thank you. Brenna Lynch, cum laude.
Bonnie Lynch.
Scott McKenzie, summa cum laude.
Alexander Mack.
Matthew Megan.
Vivian Manzapoulos.
Julia Markey, cum laude.
Nichelle Matthews.
Robert Matgizek, summa cum laude.
Melissa Maza, cum laude.
Michelle McDonald.
Claire Minnie, magna cum laude.
Josh Mejia, cum laude.
Tyler Mendoza. Kevin Mendez Asensio. Musanali Mahodali.
Shainu Malau, cum laude. Shayna Malo, cum laude.
Tyler Joseph Mooney, cum laude.
Leslie Ann Morales.
Benjamin Morales.
Devlin Morales.
I'll read it again. Benjamin Morales. Mackenzie Murphy, summa cum laude.
Jacqueline Morano, cum laude.
Gabriel Nardelli.
Cindy Miskova, magna cum laude.
Suba Naket.
Paige Nardo. James Nelson, summa cum laude.
Neji Noel.
Joseph Nato, magna cum laude.
Joanna Novak.
Kelsey O'Connor. December 2020 grad. Kelsey is walking.
Kyle Uraha, summa cum laude.
Elif One.
Jason Marcus.
Zachary Osborne. No. Yes, I see you. Jennifer Osborne. Jillian Pappas.
Jillian Parker, summa cum laude.
Jennifer Parlow.
Samantha Perella, magna cum laude.
Sachin Patnik, magna cum laude.
Ryan Pavich.
Casey Padone. Jolina.
Stefano Piscitelli, cum laude.
Jolina Maria Poldalski, magna cum laude.
Danielle Polito.
Shannon Pratt, cum laude.
Joshua Presampti.
Cameron Pooley.
Jonathan Puma, magna cum laude.
Diana Quinteros.
Thukbir Rahman.
Leslie Ramirez.
Alexandra Ribaletto, magna cum laude.
Katie Rose Redhead.
Anita Richet, summa cum laude.
Sandra Richardson.
Garrett Richter, cum laude.
Kevin Rogers, magna cum laude.
Nadia Rosa.
Ariana Rosenthal, cum laude.
Margaret Ross, summa cum laude.
Alexander Rott.
Alexa Rudley.
Tyler Cian Deverteri.
Shnuya Villar St. Fard.
Gabrielle Samuel.
Larabe? Larabe Server, summa cum laude.
Javier Sanchez. Lareba Server, summa cum laude.
Delante Helms.
Infinity Scarborough.
Blake Schnell, summa cum laude.
Hannah Schrader.
Garvita cum laude, magna cum laude, Asharma, magna cum laude.
Diane Sheehan, cum laude.
Gabriella Serpico.
Caitlin Shu, cum laude.
Kirolis Shahata.
Gabrielle Silverstrom, cum laude.
Kate Marshall Simsu Wangko, laude.
Kate Sivin.
Jared Solero.
Eva Smith, summa. Eva Smith, summa cum laude.
Huntley Spencer.
Noe Sarto.
Aaron Stavola.
Aishin Sprague.
Dwayne Steinhoff.
Moesha Stewart.
Allison Strauss, cum laude.
Samantha Stewart.
Oh, I'm sorry. Oh. Jamiley Suero. Cerise.
Ian Cerise, cum laude.
Lauren Taglienti, summa cum laude.
Ava Marie Tapie.
Taraya Tranquil.
Maria Tespiuk.
Malena Urban, summa cum laude.
Justin Ullman, cum laude.
Joanna Ui.
Franklin Vega.
Allison Van Cott, cum laude.
Kyle Van Gordon.
Eric Wagner, cum laude.
Tasfia Wahid. Jacquel Webb.
Aiden Walsh.
Shannon Whitaker. Casey Williams.
Danielle Willis.
Chendi Hugh. Cum laude.
Suban Saheed.
Melissa Zappa Sadi.
Hubin Zhang.
Jihan Zaman. Keegan Ziegler. And today's virtual participants.
Jonathan Acosta Umansor.
Rita Amamu Okansi, Joseph Amarando, summa cum laude, Alex Andervakovich, Dallin Ashdown, Risha Behan, Thomas Beninati, Anna Borelli, Danielle Brown, cum laude, Christopher Bruner, Edward Buckler, Kwame Bush, Paige Capobianco, Anthony Caratoro, John Michael Castro, Anthony Catapano, Derek Chan, Karen Coliburn, cum laude, Jamilet Quaylar, Benjamin DiStefano, Karen Desai, Raquel DiGiacomo, Kenneth Edick, Ashley Evans, Sean Farnham, summa cum laude, Daryl Ferguson, Gabrielle Fernandez, Roy Ferrara, Parvati Francis, Lauren Jenna, Vincent Jacalone, magna cum laude, Lena Gluck, Samantha Gabulis, magna cum laude, Olivia Guerrero, cum laude, Marie Gunishev, Cameron Halsall, Daniel Hartman, Arianda Haskellen, Lily Hayes, magna cum laude, Adrian Hermanis, Jason Hines, Melanie Hall, Samantha Hubner, magna cum laude, Felicio Dongheng, Kennedy Itzkowitz, Kirsten Johnson, Brendan Joyce, cum laude, Jamily Jules, summa cum laude, Victor Koh, Anjali Kinariwala, Jane Kim, magna cum laude, Shahir Khan, cum laude, Zoe Katsaros, Kiara Luna, magna cum laude, Chu Jang Liu, Kiana Lam Landolfi, summa cum laude, Jeffrey Livingston, cum laude, Stephen Lin, Archer Lim, cum laude, Jacqueline Lieber, Ryan Lennox, Sydney Lee, cum laude, Yingfeng Li, magna cum laude, Judy Lay, Brian Morrissey, Christina Moreno, Harry Miller, Shannon McHugh, Aiden McElroy, Gabriella Myers, Cody Matthews, Isabella Martino, magna cum laude, Jason Marcus, Abigail Marr, summa cum laude, Andrew Nam, summa cum laude, Shauna Nordine, cum laude, Daniel Ofori, India Pagan, Yvonne Pissarro, magna cum laude, Lisa Patel, Bianca Paul, Skylar Pickle, magna cum laude, Imad Rafi, Juan Riasco, Jordan Rickles, Lily Robinson, cum laude, Domingo Rodriguez, Christian Rodriguez, Giselle Ravello, Skunvia St. Fard, Abira Sajid, Eric Sanford, Sumaira Said, cum laude, Patrick Scharf, cum laude, Anthony Scheller, cum laude, Christopher Schwingel, summa cum laude, Eric Sclafani, magna cum laude, Ye Young So, Pantanjali Sharma, cum laude, Jasmine Sparling, O'Neill Stanberry, Jarui Sun, Yvonne Tan, magna cum laude, Shannon Tian, Zamansky Chum, Jeremy Mark Varillas Corder, Sophie Wenner, Selwyn Wilkes Jr., Derek Wong, Rachel Wong, Julia Wass, Rong Wu, and last but not least, Huyi Jin Zhou, summa cum laude.
At this time, I would like to invite all candidates for professional, master's, and bachelor's degrees and advanced certificates to rise. President McInnis, these students have met the graduation requirements set by the Board of Trustees. As the representative of their faculty, I am proud to present them to you and respectfully request that you confer upon them the degrees and certificates for which they are qualified.
By the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees, and upon recommendation of the faculty, I confer degrees upon all of you who have completed the respective requirements with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities pertaining thereto. As tradition goes, there comes a time during the ceremony when the graduates are asked to turn their tassel from one side of their cap to another to signify the earning of a degree. You are now graduates of Stony Brook University and may now turn your tassels from right to left and toss your caps. Congratulations. Congratulations, class of 2021. We conclude our ceremony with a special alumni message and presentation of our alma mater by the spirit of the Stony Brook Marching Band.
Congratulations, class of 2021. We did it.
On behalf of the Stony Brook Alumni Association, congratulations to you, class of 2021. Good luck with your future endeavors.
Congratulations, Seawolves. I am so, so proud of you. You did it. I cannot wait to see what you accomplish. Go out and conquer the world. I am rooting for you. Flowers to you. Congratulations.
Hello, class of 2021. Congratulations on achieving your goal of graduating from Stony Brook University.
Congratulations to the class of 2021. You guys did it. Welcome to the alumni family.
Hey, class of 2021. You had to overcome many hurdles this year, but you've persevered and accomplished so much. But don't stop now, this is just the beginning. Congratulations, class of 2021.
Congratulations to the Stony Brook University class of 2021. You've endured a truly historic senior year and nothing can stop you now. So get out there and show the world what Seawolves are made of.
You're now armed with a great education from one of the nation's best universities. It's time to go out and make your mark on this world, just like the 200,000 plus alums who've come before you. To the class of 2021, congratulations. Enjoy this day, and remember, you're a Seawolf for life.
Congratulations, class of 2021. My name is Rob DeBrower, class of 87, and president of your Alumni Association. Congratulations again, stay connected, and involved.
Congratulations, class of 2021. Welcome to the Alumni Association.
Grateful cheer for Stony Brook.
all our graduates and their families, congratulations. Our ceremony is now concluded. Thank you.